I created Species Nutrition with one mission in mind: to provide bodybuilders and serious athletes with no-nonsense supplements that work. I put my name and reputation on every bottle of Species Nutrition products. If you want to be your absolute best, join the evolution.
And welcome back to Muscle in the Morning. I'm Tyler, this is Baxter. Hey, quick shout out to the comments section, to Moonstruck. You have a beautiful, very romantic username, first of all. And you think I should go bummy started for lifting? You guys can't tell, look at my little muscles. I've been doing like 7 to 10 curls a day. You guys do more? We have another fully loaded Recap Wednesday ready for everyone today. And sorry in advance if I mispronounce any names. Let's get right into last weekend's action at the Girl Power Pro, where the big headline comes from your bikini winner, Romina Basualdo, who put together one of the better looks that we've seen from her in a while to cruise to an easy win here. Second place finisher, Rijuana Harley, got her season off to a strong start with what might have been her all-time best here, as she managed to gain the upper hand on third place finisher, Jess Machado, who also got her season off to a strong start here as well. Slide into fourth, we had Janine Herrera, who also won the 40 plus bikini here. And fifth place finisher, Kimberly Bonillo, rounded out a very strong top five group. We also want to give an honorable mention shout out to 50 plus winner, Betty Jean Tokunaga, for snagging the first win of her career in the Masters division. Up in the Pacific Northwest, the Emerald Cup rolled back into town, and we're starting off our recap here in the 40 plus men's physique, where we saw a big time performance from your winner, DeJuan Freeman, who's had a really nice start to the season so far. Second place finisher, David Odom, put together one of his best efforts of the season en route to adding another top five finish to his resume. Veteran Mark Sindian comfortably fit in the third here, which bumped Rich Gonzalez down to fourth. Although he probably wasn't too disappointed, considering that he did end up walking away with the 50 plus trophy here. And right out the top five, we have another longtime veteran in Jeff Robbins. It was a great day to be a figure athlete here because they had three different divisions and a lot of stage time to hand out. But it was an even better day for Dr. Adrian Matthews, who won both the 40 plus and 45 plus titles with ease. So big congrats to her for a tremendous weekend here. The runner-up spot went to Christine Albritton, who also finished in second in the 45 plus division as well. It was a weekend to remember for third place finisher Sarah Tashner, thanks to her big win in the 50 plus division. The fourth place slot went to Tracy Miller, and rounding out the top five, we had a strong performance from Stacy Gladwell. Outside of the pro and amateur action over at the Emerald Cup, we also had some outstanding guest posing action from both Hunter Labrada and Stu Sutherland. They were both really impressive here, albeit for different reasons. In Hunter's case, the new size and smaller waist that he's added to his arsenal this year were already apparent. And if you're a Hunter fan, that's an exciting prospect because it means your guy is going to be a force to be reckoned with this year. And for Stu, who was last year's NPC USA champ, and a former Emerald Cup winner, this might have been his own personal coming out party, because what he did there last weekend generated a ton of buzz ahead of his rookie debut at the New York Pro. And if these two end up parlaying this into a strong start to their seasons, we might look back on this in a few months and view it as a telltale sign of what was coming down the road. And our last update of this Recap Wednesday comes to you courtesy of the team over at the Masters Olympia, following their release of the official lineups for each of their respective divisions. There's a ton of names on all these lists across all the divisions, so we won't get too far into the weeds here, but we do want to highlight a few folks you might want to keep an eye on, including former 212 Olympia champ Kamal Algarni, who will be competing in the open division. It looks like we'll also see Josh Lenardowicz and Hidetada Yamagishi make their return to the stage after a couple of long layoffs in the open and the 212. And in classic physique, we got former Arnold Classic champ Alex Cambronero coming in as the early favorite. So all in all, these initial rosters look like they're going to be stacked across the board, And at the very least, this one seems like it's shaping up to be one of the more entertaining events we've got scheduled this year. You know, it's gonna be a lot of fun watching how this all plays out over the next few months. And that'll do it for yet another muscle. What did I say muscle in the morning in the beginning? Midday muscle. It's midday muscle.